Hello everyone. So now I am going to share my next assignment. This assignment related to the data quality analytics. So I need to use a technology Power BI. This is the source link. This is the Google Drive link, and from where we have to take data. So I need to do a visualization on basis of this column chart. I have to use this column chart, pie chart, wedge, KPI card, slicer, line chart, and tables. Okay. The requirement is I have to analyze different KPI of machines based on the different suppliers. From the source sheet, KPI, overall equipment, effectiveness, on-time delivery, utilization, downtime are different KPIs captured on the particular data. So I need to identify the data quality issues prefer sheet DQ. So there are some data. Now I will show you the data set data quality, and there are multiple rows where data is missing which causing issue in data quality. So use different visualization to identify the issues in the machine reason, location, and the machine type. Use blank values to create measures which will identify the issues. Create visualization to show missing downtime and utilization, missing repair cost, and the production quantity. Number of machines having downtime, number of machines having repair cost. Some example is less than some value, for example 400. So I need to create the report like this. I need to add the text box like this, machine KPI analysis. Then I need to analyze this machine data and then data quality analysis. So for this, here is given, I need to analyze the missing data, blank data, and do some visualization on that. So I need to do this report also. Okay. So let's move towards I need to add this one table also, machine details. Here machine ID, year, quarter, month, day, on-time delivery, overall equipment, effectiveness, utilization, downtime, and production quantity should be there. So we will move towards Power BI desktop, and I will show you my report. So let's see the data sets first. Okay. So how I imported, I will show you. Go to the get data and select Excel workbook, and go to that folder where we have downloaded that file by using that link. That this link here given some one link for data source. So we need to download the data from there, and then we need to get data by Excel workbook. Okay. So I have did that already. I will show you the data. So this is the location, supplier, machine ID, overall equipment, effectiveness, on-time delivery, utilization, downtime, production quantity, repair cost, and the date. This data are present in this DQ table. Then next is the KPI. So we can see here employee, supplier, machine ID, and this data are present in the deemed location. Location and the reason are present. Okay, and then one deemed machine. In the deemed machine, there is a present machine type and machine IDs. Okay, so let's move towards our report, and I will show you how I created. So I have taken one text box from insert, go to text box, insert the one text box, then write this machine KPI analysis as a heading. Okay, I change this background color, and okay, after that I have added these cards for seeing the supplier count. Okay, so I have taken this card from visualization pane, and then I have taken the supplier field in the fields, and then did the count of that. Okay, we can see here are some options. So I need the count. Okay, I did that. And then there are 17 count of machines. So I take one card from here. Then I have added the machine IDs. And then I need to find a count. Then I have selected the count distinct. Okay. So it will give you a count of that machine. So there are 5 suppliers are present. and the 17 machines are present in our data. Okay, next is I have created this bar pie chart. From here I have taken visual from visualization, and we can see I have taken legend as supplier. So we can see here in this field we I added supplier as legend, and the values, the count of machine IDs. Okay, so it gives us a data for this supplier. So this HP, so this data showing the supplier HP and count of machine ID for HP is 32%. It's a 34 and the 32.38% is okay. This is the mod, then all. The second one is the supplier is ABC. Count of machine ID is 32. Then this, and then this. So here is given count and the percentage also. Okay. Now this we can able to see the data in easy manner by using the pie chart. Next, I have added the slicer, three slicers here for the year. So there is only 1 year present, 2020. After adding year, we can do some formatting also. We can go to general and we can change the orientation also. If we want like this, we can do. So now I want like vertical. Okay. So next, I taken this slicer, same from visualization pane. And here I have added the machine type from this dim machine table. Here is the machine ID, machine type column is there. So I need I taken that, and this is the slicer showing this all type of machine, heavy equipment, main equipment, and support equipment, and blank data is also there. Okay, so now this is the machine IDs. So just a minute, I have to uncheck. Okay, so these all are the machine IDs I have taken from this data. Need to click on this, and then I have added the slicer from visualization pin. Select machine ID, okay, as a field. It will give you a machine IDs, how many machine IDs are there, and we can filter that machine IDs, and we can see the data for particular machine ID and for particular machine type and for that particular year. Okay, so this is the on-time delivery by machine ID. So I have taken this machine ID and on-time delivery from this KPI table as a values, on-time delivery, and as axis machine IDs. So we can see here machine ID is SP1 and on-time delivery time is 5.06. okay, so we can see for this all machine IDs, this gauge. Okay, so here on the visualization pane, here is the option of gauge. We can select that for this, and then we can do some formatting from here. We can change the data labels. If I off the data table labels, here not any value are shown. So I need to on that. I can change the color of the data labels. I can increase the size. Okay, and whatever we want to change as a style, we can change that from this format option. Okay, so then we have to move towards the next. So this is the button I have added from this insert. Go to insert. Here is the option of button, and we can add any button from them. I change the background. Okay, then we can do any type of styling from here. So I need to click on this switching between the two pages. Okay, so this is the data quality analysis. Okay, this is the text box as I taken from this insert text box, and I added this as a heading. Okay, this is also the back button I have taken from these buttons. I changed the background color, and I have did some styling there also. Then next, this is the line chart. Okay. From visualization, we can take line chart. And I have added this. In the axis, I have taken the from data quality table. I have taken the the month. From this date hierarchy, I have taken the month. And as in the values downtime, downtime. Okay, so I am able to see the downtime by month. Okay, on the in the October, November, and December. Okay, so in the October downtime is 6.07. In the November, the downtime is 4.80, and in the December, the downtime is 4.20. Okay, so the next is okay. So I will show you some. I have created some measures. So this is the measure. So this is the measure blank downtime. Okay. So I need to create measures for showing the missing data, blank data from these fields. Okay. So blank downtime equals to calculate count rows DQ filter DQ is blank. I need to use this function is blank and the table name DQ and the downtime is the column name in that table name. So equals to true. Then I get the data of blank. So as that I have created the other field, other measure called blank product quantity equals to calculate count rows. This is the calculate function, then count rows from DQ and filter all that counts the rows from the DQ table and filter on the DQ for is blank in the production quantity column from the DQ table. Okay. So if this is the true and the production quantity equals to zero, it will give us a values like it will give just a blank. Okay, so this is also I have created. The next one is the blank repair cost. So here is also same function are used, calculate count rows from DQ, filter DQ is blank. If repair cost is blank, it will give us a blank data. Okay. Next is blank utilization. Same, calculate count rows filter DQ is blank from utilization. If true, it will give us a blank data. Okay, so then as like I have created these four measures. Okay, so I will show you this. This is the clustered column chart I have taken from visualization pane, and here I have taken the blank downtime and the blank utilization. As our problems in the our problem statement, we have to analyze this missing repair cost and production quantity, downtime by month, missing downtime and utilization. Okay, so for that I have created this missing data. So this chart showing missing downtime and missing utilization by month. So in the October, there is a three downtime, blank downtime is three, and the date and the blank utilization is three. Okay, in the November, the blank downtime is two and the blank utilization is four. So we can analyze the missing data also likewise. And then next is the blank production quantity and the blank repair cost by month. So we can see in the October, there is blank production quantity is 19 and the repair cost is 9. Okay, and likewise this for November and December also. Then I have taken one line chart from this visualization pane for the repair cost by month. So we can see this is the repair cost for October month. This is the repair cost for November. This is the repair cost for December. Okay, so our report is created like that. And from here, I can move back on this report. And from here, if I have to see the data quality analysis, I can do that. And I can click on that. And I will see this also. Okay, so I will show you the table. I have created this machine details table